We'll collect data from this cart on this track before, during, and after it collides into a barrier at the end of the track. The track provides a relatively low friction surface for the cart to roll along. The cart has a force sensor on this side of it. Notice that the force sensor reports positive values when you pull on it, and it reports negative values when you push on it. We will add post-it notes to remind ourselves which direction is negative and which direction is positive for the force that is reported by the sensor when it makes contact with something in the system. We will zero the force sensor next. After doing this, you'll still notice that its value fluctuates by about 0.01 newtons, which are the limits of accuracy for the sensor. We will next calibrate the initial position of the cart. We are setting its current position to zero now. Notice that when the cart is rolled to the right of this initial zero position, the value for its reported position becomes more positive, and when it's rolled to the left, it becomes more negative. Because the direction of the coordinate system is now defined, the rate the cart is moving will also be reported as a positive or negative value. When the computer reports the rate of the cart, it'll label it as the velocity of the cart. Velocity is a term that is used to describe the rate that something is moving when the measurement being reported is a vector. Velocity is a vector because it has a magnitude, which we commonly refer to as speed, and it has a direction, which along this horizontal track can have either a negative or positive value. Let us now record the mass of this cart before we collect velocity and force data from two different collisions with the barrier at the end of the track.